got us here. And I am so sorry for the lack of videos. That just, it's been really crazy the last 2 years, probably even before that. But the last 2 years especially have just been nuts for us. We thought, this year we thought, oh, everything was better. But it kind of went crazy again. And, you know, and I know you guys have heard those excuses for me before. I kind of sugarcoat everything and just say it's been crazy. But really, truthfully, my mom has been dealing with cancer, and she has an autoimmune disease, and the autoimmune disease keeps bringing the cancer back. So we were trying to regulate the autoimmune disease, but it doesn't seem like that's going to happen real well. I mean, she takes medication for it, but yours, because the autoimmune disease that she has changes, they have to adapt the medication to the change. Well, that brings back the cancer cells in the same area. So this time, this is the third time she's gotten it back, always in the same area. And this particular time, the doctors and her, I think we're just going to opt for surgery, because I think we go for a consultation in a couple weeks to with a surgeon and get, you know, best case scenario, worst case scenario, and deal with it. But we're pretty sure we're just going to have it all removed. She's going to get some reconstructive surgery, and then she doesn't have to deal with it anymore. And hopefully this will take care of the problem. The doctors that we've talked to that did the biopsies, things like that, are really optimistic that this will take care of the problem. We need to talk to the surgeon and see what he says, but we're pretty positive that this will take care of that particular situation. Not to say that she won't get cancer somewhere else, but seeing as this has been the third time in the same exact spot, where she's just done dealing with it, it's better just to do the surgery, cut it out, and be done with it. So, the real reason for this video is because of what the Book Buddy-a-thon. I love the Book Buddy-a-thon. It helped me with keeping my mind off of all the situations. I didn't get to go on Twitter a lot, but I did get to read a lot. I kind of tried to focus on that and try to keep up with my reading, because when I get a chance to read, it's in increments, like maybe a half hour here, a couple hours at night, you know, 20 minutes here, blah, 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 and I just kind of add them up. So this read-a-thon was perfect because I could do little sprints when I had the chance. So I had a blast. I loved it. If you guys didn't get to do it, check it out. It was fun. I mean, the best. And maybe next year you guys will be able to join in. Anyways, the first book I finished, and actually it was just a book I was already reading, and I finished it because I had to go back to the library. And that was Every Last Breath. So it wasn't for a challenge or anything like that. And I read the last 98 pages of that. So I sent that back to the library. It's by Jennifer L. Armentrout. It is her Dark Elements series. It was fantastic. Of course, anything by Jennifer L. Armentrout that I've read so far has been fantastic. And believe me, I've read a lot of stuff by her. The readathon started. I read, it said to pick a book that, or have your buddy pick a book, which Jade did, which, by the way, Jade's not here because she went into a reading slump and only read half a book. So she just couldn't get out of it. She kept trying to pick up the book. I told her to try other things, but she was determined to get this one book done, and she just got stuck in the slump and couldn't finish. But anyways, the book she picked for me was Sealed with a Lie by Kate Carlton, and it was 244 pages. I finished this. I loved it. I read the first one. This is the sequel to it. Still adorable. But I definitely enjoyed this. I love teen spy novels. I love the whole idea about it. I was a huge fan of the CW's Nikita. Love that. So anything to do with spies, girls that can kick butt, you know, the gadgets, things like that. I am so there. Okay. Anyways, on to the next book. The next book was, or the next challenge was, read a book with your buddy. Okay. I did that, and of course Jade did but that's okay. I finished Sloppy First, which is so funny because it's her book series, and that's what, and I went along with her and I read it. I did enjoy it. It's not my favorite contemporary. It's not my favorite series. I know people love this book a ton. I liked it, you know, but I mean, it kind of puts you in that whole Judy Blume mindset type of book. Definitely fun. It was a quick read. It was only 290 some pages. Yeah, 298 pages, so it didn't take very long. And the way it's set up is kind of like a diary for every day. So there was lots of gaps and spaces. So it was an easy read. I would give it, I think I gave it the three stars on Goodreads. Okay. And this book was also my pick for the third challenge, which was your buddy's favorite colors. Well, Jade's favorite colors are this green color here, this orange, and yeah, she likes neon greens, oranges, purples, things like that. So these were her favorite colors. So the purple's up in here. So she wanted me to read this for that because it had all of her crazy colors. And honestly, I don't think I own any other books with these kind of crazy colors. So it worked out. So I did that for the challenge. I finished it. And then I went on to the next one was read a book your buddy gave 5 stars to. Well, Jade didn't give a whole lot of books 5 stars. Well, I read a different book because I had to finish a challenge that we picked for our TBR jars. So I didn't complete that challenge, but I did read the book. It was, Hidden Wings by Cameo Renee. It was a really decent book. I enjoyed it. I actually picked up the second book in the series, and I'm reading that now. I'm doing them on my Kindle, and I believe these are the Read With Me books by Benjamin of Tomes. I think it's for his reading, his thing. So I'm actually reading the second book in the series right now. I am enjoying this a lot, this series a lot, and I think I gave it 4 stars. On Goodreads. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure I did. Okay, and that was 204 pages. So that was kind of my read what I wanted to type of thing, but it also went with Benjamin of Tomes, and he loved the series, and he was giving it 5 stars. So I think I kind of cheated, but oh well, I read it anyways. So like I said, I improvised because I was going to read Sophie and Carter, but after reading Sloppy First, I didn't want to do another contemporary, so I kind of went to this because I wanted to read what Benjamin of Tomes and his group was reading, so I decided to do that. And then the next one was Read What You Want, which for me, Jade and I are doing TBR jars, like I said, and we were doing 2 picks this month because we missed last month, and just because of everything was so crazy. And that pick was, let me see if I can pull this up. It was Wide Awake by Danielle Lanzarotto. And the only complaint I got of this book, I think I gave it 4 stars. The editing isn't really well. The proofreading, all that stuff, she really needed a really good proofreader and editor. But other than that, I thought the story was pretty good. I enjoyed it a lot. I gave it 4 stars. And then I started the second book to the Hidden Wings trilogy. I think it's a trilogy? No, it's a series. I think there's 4 books in it. And I started the second one. And I think I read about 60 pages into that. So if you count everything, I read 1,184 pages, if you count all the pages I read. If you take out the sequel, then I only did 1,124 pages, which is fine. Either way you look at it, I think I did pretty good. So I'm really happy with it, especially with everything going on. I'm really happy with the progress. So if you guys did it, and if you guys participated in the Buddy-a-thon, let me know below. I'll definitely be looking forward to doing another one because it was fun. And maybe next time I'll pick a new buddy because Jade doesn't seem to keep up with me. All right, guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.